And Megan, thanks very much. Team coverage continues now with WMAR 2 News' Mark Roper. He's at the Baltimore Convention Center with more on what health experts are saying about people who've already gotten the Johnson & Johnson vaccine.
Yeah, good morning, Christian. It's 6 cases out of 7 million doses already given of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. So Dr. Fauci says your chances of getting sick are rare, but pausing vaccinations does give them some time to find out some more information. You know, many people eager to get the Johnson & Johnson vaccine like the fact that it only required one dose. Basically, you are one and done, but now the use of the J&J vaccine is on hold, at least until health officials can figure out why 6 women developed blood clots after getting the vaccine. The women are between the ages of 18 and 48 years old, and they got sick about 6 to 13 days after getting vaccinated. The clots formed in veins of the sinus, which prevents blood from draining out of the brain. One woman died, another is in critical condition, and officials say there's no evidence showing the vaccine caused the condition, but the CDC and the FDA are putting the use of the J&J vaccine on hold at federal sites until they can learn more. At least 48 states are doing the same, as well as places like Walgreens and CVS. Many appointments have been canceled or rescheduled to use the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines. Despite these sudden changes, Dr. Fauci is trying to calm people's fears by reminding people of their chances of getting sick.
So you're talking about tens and tens and tens of millions of people who've received vaccine with no adverse effect. This is a really rare event. If you look at what we know so far, there have been 6 out of the 6.85 million doses, which is less than 1 in a million.
Now, as officials call the chances of getting sick from the Johnson & Johnson vaccine a rare event, you're actually twice as likely to be struck by lightning at a chance of 1 in 500,000. Reporting live in downtown Baltimore, Mark Roper, WMAR 2 News.